Hey everybody, Kelsey here and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm super excited that Adobe has announced media replacement for motion graphics templates, or as I like to call MOGRTs. MOGRTs is the file extension for motion graphics templates. And if you guys are new to MOGRTs, essentially they were created so you can easily create lower third templates or logo reveal templates or transitions and be able to drag and drop them from your central graphics panel and easily customize it to save time. And now with this new media replacement, now you can have an image file or a movie file be replaceable. So you could have a logo opener with a logo and save it as a template and change that logo for every video that you're making, or change the video file that's playing in the background. So for this video, I'm going to be using this broadcast package template. I'm going to show you how to add your own media replacement with that file, which I've included down in the description box below, and how to then export it as a motion graphics template that you can use inside of Premiere Pro. Now, this update is currently available in the public beta of Adobe right now. So that means that you need to update the most recent public beta and you open it up there and enable media replacement from the beta menu, and you'll be able to start testing this out and using it. But before we jump in, a little bit about today's sponsor, vidIQ. I first learned about vidIQ when I was at the social media conference in San Diego. I just saw their banner and I was like, what's that? And I heard that other YouTubers were using it and they were successful. And so I reached out to them and signed up, and I've been using it ever since because I've seen a huge boost in subscribers and in the views on my videos. So how does it work? The way it does it is through SEO optimization, keyword searches, and helping you research trending video topics. So I use the boost plan of vidIQ, which essentially gives me suggestions for titles and keywords that will help move my video up in terms of search engine optimization. So it will suggest keywords that will help improve the searchability of my YouTube videos. And it has a checklist on the right saying, hey, did you add this to a playlist? Did you add a card to your video to connect it to other videos? Did you add a YouTube end screen? Did you add a pinned comment to your video? All of these different things impact the searchability and success of your video. Another really cool thing about vidIQ that I love is that you can preview what your YouTube thumbnail will look like based off of a search keyword. So if you're producing a video on, let's say, motion graphics templates, you can search to see how your thumbnail will perform against the other existing videos. So there's a lot of really cool things that you can do, including searching for trending topics and see how many views per hour these videos are getting. So it can help you come up with ideas that are trending in the moment now. So if you want to get vidIQ, you can take advantage of their Black Friday sale and you can get up to 30% off by going to my link below, and you can spin their little wheel of fortune that they have to get a deal on your own plan. If you guys have any questions about vidIQ, just leave a comment below. Thank you so much, vidIQ, for sponsoring, and let's go ahead and jump into the tutorial. So here inside of After Effects, I have this business broadcast package template for After Effects that I downloaded from Envato Elements. And one of the compositions I'd like to turn into a motion graphics template is the sponsored one comp. So if I double click to open this up, you can see here that it's this hexagon sponsored by animation, and we can put a logo in here, which we can turn into a media replacement. So the first step is to replace this logo and have an image file ready to be put into the central graphics panel. So let's double click to open up this pre-comp sponsored logo, double click, and here we can drag in any logo that you want. I'm going to drag in the vidIQ logo. So now that I have the vidIQ logo in here, I'm going to press S on my keyboard to scale this down. And from here, this is where we can open up the Essential Graphics panel and start adding media to customize our template. So go up to Window and go to Essential Graphics. From here, we need to select the primary composition. So from here, we're going to select the sponsored one comp as our primary. So just select the dropdown. You can see I have a ton of compositions here because this is a template. You may just have a couple of them here. I'm actually going to press S to jump down to the S section here. And I'm going to select sponsored one. Then we can name it. I'm just going to call it sponsored by Hexagon. And then we can drag in this media file. It can be a movie file or it can be a logo file. And when you drag and drop it, voila, it creates a media placeholder. And from here, we can just call it replace media. And now when we go back to our main comp, you'll see that actually it's filled in white, this logo, because it has a fill effect on this pre-composed composition here. If you press E on your keyboard, it'll show you that there's actually a fill. If you want to be able to turn this fill on and off inside of the motion graphics template, you can actually take this all mask feature here and drag this parameter into the essential graphics panel. And here when you select off, it turns it on and off again. So you can have the choice of the end user to be able to turn this fill on or off. So we can call this turn fill on slash off. And if you want to be able to customize the color of the fill, this is where you can actually drag in this color fill layer. Now there is an expression attached to this color. So to turn that off, you can hold the Alt or the Option key if you're on a Mac and select that and it'll turn it off. And it will go to red by default, but that's okay because if we drag this color parameter into the Essential Graphics panel, we can then select red and make it white. And then your end user can decide what that fill color will be. Another thing you may want to control is the position and the scale of this logo. So if you go back to this sponsored logo and press P to bring up the position controls, you can also drag this into the panel. And let's go back and press S to bring up the scale and drag and drop this here. Now this will enable the end user to then use these parameters to reposition and rescale the logo however they like. Especially if they're going to replace this logo, it's important to include these parameters so that way you can rescale it and reposition it to fit the logo that you're replacing. So there's probably going to be a few other things you want your user to control, such as the text and the color of the background here. So for the text, the sponsored by text, you can actually toggle down here and go to text, and within that is source text. And that's what you can drag into the panel to be editable. So here we can call this edit text. And so they can control what this says if you want to edit sponsored by. It can be brought to you by or whatever the person wants to type in. Better yet, you can select edit properties and choose font properties. So if you want to enable custom font selection, check that. Enable font size adjustment, enable faux styles, and hit OK. And this will allow the end user to change the font and the size, etc. If you want to be able to edit the color of the text, this is another thing that is related to an effect added here called fill, just like before. It also has an expression tied to it, so we want to remove that in this specific case. So again, just hit the Alt key on a PC or the Option key on a Mac and select that stopwatch and drag and drop this color up, and we can call this text color. And then we can change this to white, and that way you can edit the color. All right, there's a couple other parameters we want to change here, but you'll notice that we can't find the color of the hexagon outline or the fill behind it. That's because it's a hidden layer in this template. If you guys are ever using templates, you might see that there's this little shy guy here. You can unselect that and it will reveal all of the hidden layers. So here you can see there's a hexagon line shape. If we toggle that open, you'll see that there's a fill here for the blue color and an expression. So let's go ahead and turn off this expression by hitting the Alt Option key. And then we can take this color and bring it up and we can call this outline color. And let's say we want to change it back to blue, just like that. And if we go down, you'll also see that there's a mask hexagon and a hexagon. The hexagon here is actually the fill behind it. But to make this more obvious, let's actually delete the background layer, which is black. So I'm just going to delete that.
And if we turn on the transparency, you'll now see that it's transparent behind this graphic, and you can see that the hexagon has a black fill. So underneath the hexagon, let's go to effects, underneath fill, and the expression, let's go ahead and press Alt Option and turn that off and drag this color in here. And let's call this hexagon fill. And let's bring this back to black, like so. Another thing you may want to be able to control is the opacity of this background. So here, let's drag this opacity here, and here you'll be able to control this opacity. So let's call this hexagon opacity. So we did all of the main color parameters here and customizations, but what if you want to control the overall position and scale of this graphic? So if you want it to be more in the center, a little bit smaller on the left, this is where we can click and lasso and select all of these layers, right click and select pre-compose. And we can just leave it as pre-comp one, hit okay. And then you can toggle down and there's some overall transform tools. And then you can drag the scale into the panel and the position. And this will allow the users in Premiere Pro to change the position if they want. So they can scale it down, reposition it like that. So let's say we want to leave it as is, just like this. What we can do before we export it is set the poster frame so that way it'll have a preview of what it looks like, and then select Export Motion Graphics Template. First, it'll ask you to save the project, so you'll want to save it. If you're working with a template, you'll probably have to save it as a converted file, which it will do automatically. I'll just call this V3 and save. And then the Export As Motion Graphics Template window will come up. You can save it to your local templates folder, which will automatically appear in your Premiere Pro Essential Graphics panel. If you're sending this to somebody else, you can save it to your Adobe Creative Cloud library, or you can save it to a local drive and then attach it to an email or send it via Google Drive. I'm just going to use the local templates folder and I'm going to hit OK. Now I'm going to go to the Premiere Pro beta. Remember, you have to be using the public beta app to be able to use this, and you need to go up to beta and make sure that the enable media replacement in motion graphics templates is enabled. So then from the Essential Graphics panel, I'm going to search for sponsored by Hexagon. And here we can drag and drop our sponsored by Hexagon on top of our footage, and you can select it. And now from the edit tab, we can then customize this. So if we wanted to bring it up, we can go down to position and bring this up. If we want to replace this logo, let's say with our Gal logo, we can just drag and drop it on top of it to replace it. And it will import a replaced media. But you'll notice that because we have the color fill on, it just made it white, right? So we need to turn that off. And now we can see our logo. So if you want to change the position or the scale of this logo, you can use the parameters that we added here. So you can scale this up and you can reposition it using these position controls. We can change the outline color to be the color of this purple if we want to. And if we wanted the fill to be a white color, we can make that white and then change the sponsored by text color to a black color. So you can really customize it to your own, and then you can just render it by hitting enter. And here's what it looks like with our media replacement. So this is gonna save YouTubers and video editors a ton of time if they want to use the same sponsored by graphic, but customize it with the brand that's sponsoring the video and the colors of that brand.
So if this motion graphics template tutorial helped you out, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. It helps me know if you guys like this content, and then I'll make some more content related to motion graphics templates. Also, be sure to hit that notification bell so you're notified when I publish new tutorials on the channel so you don't miss out. And also a huge thanks to all of the patrons that support me each month. I appreciate your support, and you can get some free templates and free direct message support from me if you have any questions on Patreon. And thanks again to vidIQ for sponsoring today's video. Don't forget to get their Black Friday deal with the link in my description. And yeah, that's it for this week's video, and I will see you next time. Bye. And I love that.